I'm gonna get you down onto the floor for this one. We're gonna do some glutes and core work. So this move, I always start standing on the band. If you don't have one of those divots in your shoes, it may roll off. So you can totally put the band on after, but keep your foot flexed. Anyway, we're coming down into what I lovingly refer to as doggy style, all right? So that means hands right below the shoulders, knees right below the hips. And then I'm gonna kick this leg back and I'm gonna lift the opposite arm forward. And what that's working is that's gonna work obviously the shoulders and the glutes and the hamstring, but you're gonna feel that whole midsection really have to pull together to keep you from falling over. Mm-hmm. Now, one thing I wanna point out, I would rather the arm just come up here, if that's as far as it can get,
okay,
than doing trying to pull it straight. It's really honestly more about the core work. Okay, so let's show everyone how you would do this move.
Oh boy. Should I start with? So if I hook it on this,
then you're gonna be lifting
my right arm.
Your right arm. Perfect. Let me move these out of the way. We'll use these in the next round. Okay. Good, keep that foot flexed. Perfect. Look, see? You can snap back.
Oh wait, sorry, I'm gonna. Okay, here you go.
Alright, so we're using the yoga block just to give Sarah a stable surface. She's gonna kick her left leg back and lift her right arm forward. Oh, it's so pretty. Two, good, we'll go to eight. Three,
whoa.
Nice and slow. Four, now this is a move, the slower you go, the more resistance you're gonna feel. Five, because we're fighting the resistance in both directions. Six, seven, one more for me, and eight. Good, let's do it switching legs, all right? So, this time you're gonna push that arm forward. Now it may not get the same range, and it may actually feel a little easier on that leg if there's a little less resistance. That's okay, at least we are using these body parts and working them out. Are you ready?
Yes.
Let's do eight to make it even. One, two, nice. Three, four, five, six, seven, last one, and eight. Awesome. Awesome. Ah, good. Get rid of that band.
Okay.
Get out of here, band. Ugh. All right, this one is something I call a plank stand-up. And the reason is because you're going to get into a plank and then you're gonna stand up.
Oh.
So it's
very self-explanatory.
I thought of the name myself. So what I do is I put my hands down and I step out into a plank. All right, and again, that perfect plank means hands right below the shoulders, hips are level versus up here or down here, right? And then I pick a leg, and it doesn't matter which leg you start with because I'm gonna make you do both. And you bring one leg in, and then you stand up just through the one leg, squeezing through the glute. So, I used to have you do these on just one hand, but now that we've been sort of using the yoga blocks, you get a little bit more of a full body move. So let's do it.
Okay.
Pick which foot you wanna start on. Arms are going down.
Let's start here.
Good, arms are going down into that perfect plank. Good, and then pick a leg, and you're gonna bring that leg in, and you're gonna stand up just through the heel. One, then step back out and do it again. Let's do three, two,
eek. I get wobbly.
But that's okay, those are those muscles working. Three, good, and let's do the other side. We'll figure out which side you prefer, right?
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. It looks good though. One, and when you're in that plank, you probably feel everything acting together.
Whoa. Yeah.
Now it's okay to wobble too, because that's just you fighting gravity in the world, and that means that the muscles are actually working. And step back in. Three, I love it. Good, do you feel it right through?
Yeah, it's actually a lot easier than it looks.
Not easy, it's a lot easier than it looks, like once you know the form.
Yeah, it works. Like it easy in a good way, not like easy.
Yeah, like easy in I'm strong and badass, so I can do this move.
Okay, what are we gonna do now?
Okay, so plank work, you hear it all the time. People hate planks. The reason they hate planks is because they're so effective. We figured out a way to make your whole body work instead of just doing a one-armed plank.
Yes.
So a move that you will see in workout classes all the time is a broken plank. Mm-hmm. And I'm gonna show everybody what a broken plank is, and then we're gonna show them how you did it. So why don't you just come hold a plank? Regular plank while I'm showing everybody what a broken plank is.
Why not?
Because planks are so amazing and they work the whole body, right? So we're in that perfect plank position, which means the arms are right below the shoulders, hips are level, and you're gonna have your feet just spread ever so slightly, because what we do from here is I'm gonna slowly come down onto one elbow and then the other elbow, and then slowly push back up and up without the hips wiggling, right? Because that's all that core works.
So I still have the wine glass on my back?
Yes. It's a margarita now. We're going stronger. All right, let's do it together. It'll be like synchronized swimming. Are you ready?
Yep.
Down. Down.
And then we push back up.
And up. Good. You keep going. There's no way I'm going to keep doing this. Good. That looks awesome. But see how steady her back is. And we have just modified.
Ooh.
And she's getting almost a push-up in. Good. Awesome. Take a break. So, broken planks, super hard.
Uh-huh.
And they work the chest and the shoulders and the back. Spider planks,
even harder.
And so I actually, two C-sections in, I now do spider planks at least at this part of my fitness on my knees.
Okay.
Used to be able to do them on my toes. I will get back there. That's okay. Our bodies are a work in progress constantly, and who's to say what a perfect body can do? So I'm gonna start on my knees, and I'm gonna show you. You're gonna come to your knees, but still in a plank. So if you're on your toes, you're here, knees right here. And then instead of pushing up like we just did in the broken plank, the arms come straight, but you'll notice my chest doesn't lift at all. And it ends up being much more this part of your abdominal tract working, right? So we did this the other day on the yoga box. Let's do it again.
Okay.
All right. So let's get you started. We'll start you off in a regular plank position on your elbows and toes. And then I'll show everybody how to find the perfect plank on their knees. So if you are here in this elbow and toe position, keeping the butt right where it is, keeping all those body parts pulling towards each other, now just lower the knees to the ground. That's it. So that is actually, you still feel it. It feels like a plank. It might not feel like quite as tough of a plank, but it feels like a plank. Mm-hmm. Good, so from there, I want you to put one arm out in front. Good, and then the other arm comes out in front. Good, hold it, and then slowly come back down. So I don't wanna dip those hips at all. Good, I want you to reach even an inch further from me, Sarah. So bring that arm nice and forward because I don't want that chest to raise at all. Good, now lift it. That's it, hold it. Slowly bring it back. Good, let's do one more because these are super obnoxious. Ready, so the arm's gonna go forward. Don't let those hips dip. Hold it. Other arm, hold it. Good, and slowly come back. Good, and you should feel how that kind of hits right here just a little bit more.
Yeah.
They're hard.
That's true.
It's like a love hate.